Good morning, Monday Clubbers. Tony here. This is week 21 of our continuation of the Marsh Bowling Club meetings we had every Monday, which were terminated in March. And this has been our antidote to privation and refusal to submit to the horrors of COVID. Last week was a portrait entitled Worried. Well, less of that and more of a little bit of relaxation. You've got a tropical island, or it could be Goa. Let's entitle it Goa. It's short and simple. It's easy to do, and it's a good antidote from the worried of last week. This is a little cutout I found in the paper this morning. It's really tiny, but I can put it here. Keep it available to the side there. Move to one side. Everything ready to go. So, so we can keep the horizon a third of the way up, which is good. I think I'd like to replace a lot of this greenery, perhaps just a hint of it here, and a beach. That'd be a nice interruption of colour there. The sky is blue, fairly dark blue, which will recede in intensity towards the horizon, as it should. And the sea is more of a greeny blue, fairly pale. I think that indicates sand underneath. And that will have the opposite flow of colour from fairly weak to dark at the horizon. Not many waves, a few ripples. So there's a hint. What is that? It's a shoreline about half a mile away. So that will balance the view across. I might simplify these palm trees as well. Okay, put that there. Enough talking. You can't really see my palette very well there. Oh well, I'll tell you what I'm doing as I go along. So get my Chinese goat hair calligraphy brush, which I like, and I'm going to start with French ultramarine. Annoying rattle. When you're mixing paint and adding water, you can't really see what I'm doing there, but if you just dip into water gently, pull water into the mix, don't swish it around, you lose all your pigment then. Right. So I've not pre-wet the paper, so I want to create some clouds here. So By that I mean leaving gaps. These can be just happy coincidences. Something looks good like that, just leave it. And paint around it. My paint. Darken this up a bit, as I said. So as long as the paint stays wet, it will all merge in nicely. So coming down, we got some more clouds, I think, to the right. I think if you try to formulate the shape of a cloud, you're in trouble. You're better off letting it make its own shape. I think this will do. So here is where its sky starts fading away to the horizon. So I'm just adding water. Sweepy, sweepy. This is a rolling wash. Keep the bottom edge alive, just take care of itself. I've already drawn a line across there, you see, third the way up. Doesn't have to be spot on, because the sea will be darker along that line. So that looks okay. Some scratches in the paper here. What's caused that? Doesn't matter, because the trees will cover it, but if those scratches were over here, that would look weird. I'd have to put a flock of geese to disguise it. And you don't get geese in Goa. Maybe you do. So that looks okay. So I'm going to turn off to let that dry. 5 minutes. Okay, that's dry now, so I can put our reference photo there. Let's put some greenery in. These look like cactuses, but I don't really care what it is. So I'm mixing bench ultramarine and cadmium lemon. And not too high up, just above the horizon. Okay, I'm going to stop there and put the sea in. I'm going to do the sea. So I'm going to use my sky mix. Just a tad of yellow. Let's see how that looks. good. Darken it. Because the sea will be dark. Come into a lighter foreground. Let's see how this looks. I can just see that pencil line, which is brilliant, right across. Lovely. The water. To weaken it. Add more yellow. More yellow. Too much yellow. I'm taking that out with a dry brush. That's okay, because I'll now just carry on with water. Okay, so that's a good base. We'll come back to that. So I'm going to carry on with the green now. The vegetation, which I stopped painting. So ultramarine, yellow. Let's put a tad of burnt umber in. Okay, back over what I did. Get some few spiky shoots. It's going to merge in with the sea a little bit. That's okay. Just stroke some neat colours into it while it's still fluid. I put a bit of yellow in there. I'm going to put a bit of sepia here and there. Back to the green. Struck it about, leave a few white flecks. To the sea and the beach. So I'll clean my palette. What's a good beach colour? I'm going to use Naples yellow, which is like a really dense yellow ochre. It's a bit dried up, this. see how this looks. Dry brush strokes. You can't see that. Oh, that's better. I should be more attentive to the customers. Okay. It's going fine. 16 minutes, so we're over halfway already. So I'm going to put the trees in. I'll just turn off to let it dry a little. I just thought I'd take advantage of this area being in a nice fluid state to draw some character lines in. It's what Miranda's mother would call character lines. This is a bluey green colour. This, or the name I can't remember. Some teaching I am. Okay. Leave the white, I think that'll be useful later. A few dark lines. Not too many. Okay, this is burnt sienna and Naples yellow. This is one of the trunks of the palm trees. I'll do the big one first, and it comes in about here. So it's just before halfway. About a third of the way down here. That was a bold move. I'll just dab it. Take a bit of colour out. The others are much lower down. Another one sneaking in from the side. About here. I'm moving it more into view. Okay, well, that's still wet. The sun is coming from the left. I'll add some shadow to the right. It's not, it's dried, isn't it? Never mind. So the brush strokes don't have to be precise. Oops, sorry. Notice that shortly. Put some lines. Okay. Palm leaves. I'll do a pale yellowy green to begin with, which won't be very visible. Where's that leaf coming from? This one. So it gets quite busy. I'm glad. See these blue lines? They were in the paper. Complain. Right, that looks a trifle weird. Don't worry. He said worry. To be windswept. Must have had a hurricane. Okay. Right. Quickly drafting in some darker greens. So, a bit haphazard here. Change brush. This is a fine, I think it's called a saber brush. It's great for doing this sort of work. It's very hard to control. Don't mind that. So it's a fairly random nature. So you've got the gist of that. Save time. I'll turn off. So I'll switch to a darker colour now. These will be shadowy parts of the foliage. Again, it's fairly random. And just build it up. Look at me, I'm like Picasso. So I'm just putting in what I think the painting needs for balance. I've got my narrow eye again. Trusty friend. Okay, 26 minutes. So these white regions I can now fill with bright colours. Bit of yellow. Bit of magenta. Bit of blue. It just seems tropical-y. Right, having another look at the sea now. So there will be a degree of roughness, fire art at sea. Maybe a couple of waves developing closer to, not too much here. Here we've got some like shadows in the water. Extremely faint. Obviously something lurking in there. Oof. Okay, so I'm happy with the beach and a hint of waves coming onto it. Just going back over tree trunks. I'm sure they've got some story to tell. Shadow around the base. Not that one. These are being shadow. I think we're done. Looks tropicky. Just gonna get some Burke is going way out at sea. And in front of this little headland, just a hint, nothing more. How are we doing? 30 minutes. Let's call it a do. So it's a Goa beach. Okay, hope you like that. Have a go at that. It's not too difficult. Now, next Monday I won't be here. I shall be in Wales, hopefully. Might do a bit of painting. And again, I might not. So I'll see you in 2 weeks' time. It's Tony signing off. This is me. Oops. Can you see that? Okay. My details. Give me a call anytime. Okay, adios.